Hello everyone, myself Mohammad Ramiz and I welcome you all on behalf of Saraswat International Academy. Today in this session we are going to learn the part 5 of chapter number 1, that is Nature and Significance of Management. So students, in the previous session we have studied about the top level management and the middle level management. We have discussed the functions of them in detail. Today we are going to learn the third part of level of management, that is bottom level management. So in the bottom level management, who works? Supervisor, jobbers and foreman. These are the persons who are included in the bottom level management. This level is also known as what? Bottom level or supervisor level. So this is the other name of the bottom level, that is supervisor level. Okay, you have to remember this for the MCQ in one line. Decisions and policies decided by whom? Decision and policy are decided by the top level management, and actually it is implemented by this level. By this level means by the bottom level. The decisions are taken by top level, and that work and the decisions are implemented by the bottom level. They are the persons who are working. Okay, therefore this level is also known as functional or operational level. So here we get the two names of the bottom level. The first is supervisor level and the second is functional, or you can also say as operational level. Supervisor working at this level are representative of management. They are the what? Representative. Representative means they are representing the different departmental head, departmental managers. The top level, they give the decisions to the different departmental head, that is the middle level of management, and the different departmental head, the different department manager, they give their decision and they give the direction to the different supervisor, and they make the people, other employees of the bottom level to work. At this level, management functions are performed less while administrative work is more. At this level, at this bottom level of management, what it is said that management functions are performed less. Okay, management function perform less means that here the policies and decisions are not taken. Here the work is done. As I had told you before in the previous session, that at the bottom level management, the physical work is done and not mental. The work of mental is about to make the policies and plan, and that is done by the top level. Now we will discuss the different functions done by the bottom level management. So the first function you can see, that is to supervise the functions of employees. Okay, here you can see the supervisor is there. So the work of the supervisor is to do the supervision, that how properly and efficiently the work is done by the employees. Now you can see the second point, to see there remains discipline. There should be a what? There should be a discipline at the workplace among the employees, and their morale is boosted. Morale is boosted means that employees should be enthusiastic and they should work with motivation. So again we will see the second point. Here it is said about what? That this supervisor will look that their discipline should be maintained among employees, and the employees should be what? Always motivated for the work. Now see the third point, to plan the routine work of the department. Okay, in the different departmental heads, that is the middle level management, they appoint the supervisors in their respective department, and this supervisor, they will plan the routine works, daily works of the department. Now the fourth point, to perform the functions related to employees, like, okay, to perform the what? Functions related to employees, like transfer of the employees, promotion of employees, and to give them the training. Now the fifth point, to get instructions, to get the what? Okay, look, these people, that bottom level management, they are going to get the instructions from whom? They are going to get the instruction from middle level management. They get the orders and programs from the different departmental officers, okay, that is middle level management, to carry out the departmental functions. So here it is said that the supervisors, they take the instruction order and the programs from the different departmental officers about how to carry their departmental function. Now the sixth point, that is to perform the functions like, which functions? To set up the layout, to set up the what? Layout of machinery, to repair and maintenance of machinery. So it is the work of the bottom level management to set up the layout, repairing and maintenance of machinery, because here is the production work will be done. And for the production, machinery is very important, and it is the responsibility of the bottom level to set up the proper layout and repair and do the repairing and maintenance of machinery. Now the seventh point, to make arrangement for necessary equipment, raw material, etc. for the workers. Okay, so it is the responsibility of the bottom level management, the supervisor, that they have to look that proper stock which is necessary for the production process is there or not. So they have to make the arrangement for the necessary equipments and the raw material. Now the next point, that is 8, to solve the genuine problems of worker. Okay, we all know that in a company there are many of the employees, and every employee have some of the problem, but all the problems cannot be set out. So the genuine problem, if it is seen by the bottom level management that some person is having some genuine problem, so that problem should be listened and should be sorted out, so that employees will be motivated. Now the ninth point, to implement a decision and policy decided by the top level management. Okay, we all know that decisions and policies and plannings are done by the top level management, and the top level management give their plans and everything to the middle level management, to the different departmental head, and this departmental head then give the responsibility to the supervisor that this work of the plans which was decided by the top level, that should be done properly at the bottom level management. So it is the responsibility of the bottom level management to implement the decisions and policy decided by the top level. Now the 10th point, to forward reports of various activities taking place at the bottom level. We have discussed in the functions that the main working is done at the bottom level management. So whatever the works are done at bottom level, the reports should be prepared for that and should be forwarded to the top level. And see next, suggestions and complaints of the employee to the middle level management. Okay, so whatever the work is done at the bottom level, that report will be formed and that report will be submitted to the middle level management, and whatever the problems are faced by the employees and the suggestions of the employees will be given by the supervisor to the different departmental head. So bottom level management, though is the lower level of management, still it is very important. Successful performance by this level leads to achievement of business objective, because here the main work is done by this persons, which provides support to the entire business. So again, here it is shown in this paragraph the importance of the bottom level management, because the top level management decides the plan, but the actual work is done at the bottom level management. So here it is said that bottom level management, though is the lower level of management, but still it is very important. Successful performance of by the levels had to achieve the business objective, and which provide the support to the entire business. Now we are going to learn the difference between the top level, middle level and bottom level management. So the first point, that is management and administration. First of all, you have to understand what is management and what is administration. For example, management decides the plan and administration implements that plan. Okay, so we will discuss this. See the first point, top level management, proportion of management is more, because here they टॉप लेवल मैनेजमेंट डिसाइड्स द प्लान, ओके, एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन फिजिकल वर्क इज लेस. नाउ सी एट द मिडल लेवल प्रोपोर्शनल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट इज लेस, हियर द मैनेजमेंट इज लेस एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वर्क इज मोर बिकॉज वॉट एवर द पॉलिसीज फ्रेम्ड बाय द टॉप लेवल देन इट इज़ गिवन टू मिडल लेवल एंड द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द मिडल लेवल इज टू मेक दैट वर्क डन. सो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लेवल इज मोर टू इम्प्लीमेंट द प्लान दैट इज डन बाय द मिडल लेवल मैनेजमेंट एंड वेयर द प्लान इज रियली इम्प्लीमेंटेड हु वर्क्स दैट इज द बॉटम लेवल. सो सी हियर द मैनेजमेंट वर्क इज टू लेस, ओके, दे डोंट डिसाइड एनी ऑफ द प्लान. द होल प्लान इज डिसाइडेड बाय द top level and the middle level also plans for their department, okay. So here in the bottom level management is too less and the administration is maximum. The maximum physical work is done over here. So includes, so at the top level management, who are there? Board of director, managing director and general manager are included in for the formation of policy. So these are the persons who are working at the top level. Now in the middle level, the different departmental officers and experts of various fields are included in it. So here the different departmental officers such as production manager, sales manager, marketing manager, human resource manager, finance manager will be there, and experts such as engineer, chartered accountant, company secretary, these are the persons who will work over here. Now at the bottom level, who works? Supervisor, jobbers, foremen, these are the persons who are included over here. Now the third point, that is authority and responsibility. Authority means what? Power. And it is said that authority comes with responsibility. So the person who are having the power, they have the works, okay. Like if a monitor is appointed, so he is now having the power. In the same way, now it is a responsibility of the monitor to look out that the discipline is being maintained in the class, okay. So now see the first point of the top level management in this. Now authority and responsibility both are more. In the top level management, the power is maximum. They are the persons who will frame the different policy, mission, vision of the business, okay. And in the same way, they are responsible. Their responsibility is maximum, because they have to take the different reports from the middle level and bottom level management. They have to give the different directions. They have to see that any external factor is affecting the business, okay. Now second, that is middle level management. See, comparatively less authority from the top level management. They have the less authority. They have the authority, they have the power for of their respective department. Production manager will have the power to take the decisions for his department, and in the same way their responsibility is limited to the department only. Production manager will take the decisions for his department and he is the responsible person for his respective department. Now the third, that is bottom level management, least authority. They don't have power, okay, while responsibility is also limited to the subdivision only. Students, we are continuing the differentiation between top level, middle level and bottom level management. Here I have written TMB at top. It shows that T for top level, M for middle level and B for bottom level management. Now we will see the fourth point, number of members. In the top level, the number of the members are very less, because here only the authoritative persons who are going to make the plans, that will be there. The director will be there. Now in the middle level, comparatively to top level, more number of members, okay. Here the different departmental head will be there. Here it will be a few. In the top level, it will be a few number of people, and comparing to top level, the at middle level, there are more number of the persons. The different departmental heads are there, the different experts are there. And in the bottom level, compared to top level and middle level, there are more number, because here maximum employees are working. So here in the bottom level, the more number of employees will be there. Now the fifth point, that is competence. Competence means the quality of being suitable. In the top level management, all round development is required. The persons who are the board of director, they should have the knowledge of all the subjects of the business and of the world also. Okay, so in the top level, all round development of the persons and all the knowledge should be there of the different subjects, because they are the persons who are going to set the mission and vision of the business. They are the persons who will frame the different policy and plans. Okay, now the middle level management, specialized knowledge is required. Okay, so like for the finance manager, he should have the proper knowledge of his respective subject of finance. For the marketing manager, he should have the proper knowledge of his respective subject of the marketing. Okay, and here the third, that is requirement of knowledge for one's own department. The person, the employees who are working, they should have the knowledge of their own department and the sub department. Now the sixth point, that is formation of objectives and policy. The top level management, this level formulates the basic objective and the policy of a company. We know this, we have seen this from the starting, that the top level management is the persons, the board of director, they are going to frame the different policies and plans for the business. Middle level management, this level implements policy formulated by the top level management. The top level frames the policy, and that policy is implemented in the business, in the company, by the different departmental head. And bottom level, this level implements the policy and decision framed by the top level and middle level management. So whatever the policies and decisions are taken by top level and middle level management are being implemented where at the bottom level management. Now the seventh point, that is accountability. Accountability means that to whom they have to answer. See, this is the top level. To whom they have to answer, this level is accountable to the shareholders, okay, to the creditors, to the government department and legal provisions. So this top level management, they have to give the answers to the shareholders in the meetings, in the general meeting, okay, that where the money of the shareholders are being used. Okay, they have to answer to the creditors, they have to answer to the government department, and they have to answer to the different legal provisions. Okay, so next is middle level. Middle level is accountable to whom? To the top level. They have to give the answers of their respective department to the top level management. And the last, that is bottom level. Bottom level is accountable to middle level. This bottom level, whatever the work has been done, they are going to submit the report to the whom? To the middle level management. Now the eighth point, that is decision. Decisions taken by this level, that is top level, are more risky and comparatively more far reaching to a large extent, because this top level, they are making the plans for the business. Okay, so whatever the decisions are taken by the top level, that is comparatively played a very important role, and it is very risky also, because if that plan fail, the whole business can be failed. And now the second, that is what middle level management. Decisions taken by this level are less risky and far reaching. So whatever the decisions are taken by the middle level management, that is going to affect to the whom? To the respective department. If any wrong decisions are taken by the production manager, that is going to affect the business, but it can be altered. Okay, so here in the middle level management, the decisions taken by this level are less risky, and bottom level management, the decisions taken by this level are least risky and far reaching. So here we complete the differentiation between the top level, middle level and bottom level management. Students, here are the textual questions. Answers of this question you have to write in your notebook.
First, we will discuss the answer in one line. First question, which fields are developed through management? The answer will be business, industries, religious, social, agriculture, army. These are the different fields which can be managed and developed through management. Now, see the second question. Which matters are included in management? So, as per the Dr. G.R. Terry, management includes man, machines, resources, methods, money, and administration. Third question, which level of management have supreme authority to manage the business? Answer will be top level management have the supreme power, supreme authority to manage the business. Now, the fourth question, what is the other name of middle level management? The answer will be officer's level. Next question, which level of management follows the order and instruction given by CEO, that is chief executive officer? The answer will be middle level management. Now, the sixth question, which level of management does the function of machinery layout and repairing? The answer will be bottom level management does the function of machinery layout and repairing. Here are the answer in short, answer in brief, and answer in detail. Here in this question, you have to write only two functions of the top level management. Then second question is, which are the persons who are included in top level management? Answer in brief, explain management as a profession. Second question, explain the functions performed by top level management. Here above it is only 2 points, here you have to write more points. Now the third question, give difference between the different levels of management that we discuss. So you have to write only 5 points about it and answer in detail. Draw a diagram of different levels of management and you have to explain their functions.